Welcome to Crazy Coders Club. In today's session, we are going to design an analog clock using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. The first step is to create the folder in the desktop. Then we'll create HTML, CSS and JavaScript documents. Then we'll beautify using CSS. Then we'll make it dynamic by adding JavaScript code. So let us start. First, I'm going to create the folder in the desktop. I'm going to name it as analog clock design. After creating the folder, I'm going to drag that folder into the Visual Studio Code. So close the welcome message. Now I'll create HTML, CSS and JavaScript documents. index.html, style.css and clock.js. After creating all these, I'm just going to bring the basic HTML template using a shortcut. Then I'm going to name it as analog clock. This will be my title. Then in the body, I'm going to have a container. Inside the container, I'm going to have my clock division, class name clock. And inside the clock division, I'm going to have three more divisions, one for hour, one for minute and one for second. For the first, I'm going to give a class name and ID name as hour. For the second one, I'm going to name it as minute. I'm just going to change the class name and ID name. For the third one, I'm going to name as seconds and seconds. I'm going to use a shortcut for all these things. So after creating the HTML document, we should start styling the styling in CSS. Before styling it, we have to link the CSS file to our HTML document. So make sure that before styling it, you are linking your CSS document to the HTML or CSS file to the HTML document. So first, I'm going to remove all the default margin and paddings. So margin 0 and padding also 0. Then I'm going to use a box sizing as border box. Let us see how it looks. I have saved the folder in the desktop. Go to desktop and open index.html in the browser. As of now, there is no CSS styling is visible in the browser. So let us start styling it. First, I'm going to give a background color to the body. Select the body and give a background color. So I have decided that I'll use a yellow color to the background. The code will be FFDD and 00. So let us refresh it. The background color has been added to browser. So next I'll style my container. So select the container. So first I'm going to give an width and height. Width of 400 pixels. And height of 400 pixels. I'm going to have a border of 1 pixel, solid and black color, because I want to trace the position transition of this particular container. So let us start giving it 1 pixel, a solid and a black color. Let us refresh it. Okay, now the container has been added. So I want the container to be in the center. So I'm going to position that container now. I'm going to use position absolute. And then I'm going to move the container left 50% and from the top 50%. Let us see. Okay, left 50% and top 50%. Okay, refresh it. Now it has moved top 50% from the top actually, from the left. Actually, I want the container to be in center. For that, I'm going to use a CSS property called transform in the transform translate minus 50% and minus 50%. This minus 50% is nothing but half of the width and half of the height. So the container should be in the center. Yes, the container has come in the center now. So next I'm going to style my division, clock division. So I'm going to select the clock, come here in the CSS. So dot clock. Okay, for clock also I'm going to do the same thing as container. First I'm going to give a width, height and the border so that I can have a look at where my container is, where my division is. So for the clock division I'm going to use a width of 325 pixels and height of 325 pixels. Okay, let us see where it is located. Yes, it is located in the corner, top corner of the container. So I want it to be in the center. For that I'm going to use position absolute. See here, if I use position absolute, it is going to take the reference of its parent. The parent here it is container, so that's why it has moved 50% from the top and 50% from the left. So as in the container, same property I'm going to use, that is transform. Now my container is in the center. So after that I'm going to give a background image for clock numbers. So for that I have already downloaded an image and kept it in my folder. It is in the desktop, in my folder, clock background. Come to the CSS file and just give its name. Since it is in the same folder, just if you give the name, it is going to take. So now the background image has been added, but it is not in its position. So for that, I'm going to use background size, a cover property, so that it will come in the center. Yes, it has come. Now I will style my container boxes. I'm going to use a border radius of 50%. I want it to be a round shape. So yes, my clock is in round shape now. I want my container also to be in the round shape. So I'm going to copy the code and paste it in the container block. Yes, let us see. Yes, my container also is round shape now. Now I will start giving the shadow effect. This is a neuromorphism effect. First I'm going to give a shadow to the container. For the container I'm going to use outside shadow. For the clock I'm going to use inside shadow. So 15 pixel, 15 pixel and 30 pixels. And little dark color. And one more thing. The color will be little white so that the background is visible. Let us refresh it. I have added the shadow to the outer edge of the container. Yes, the shadow effect has been added. Now I'll remove the border. I don't need any more because I have already tested how the position transition happens. Let us refresh it. Now it looks better. Yes. Now we are going to add a box shadow effect to our clock. So in this, I'm going to add to the inner edge of the clock. So let us paste the same code. The only thing we need to modify, we need to add is inset. This particular keyword will add the shadow inwards. Refresh it. Yes, the shadow has been added. Let us remove the border here also. Now it looks much better. Now only thing remaining is minute, hour and seconds hands, and also making it dynamic using JavaScript code. So for the now I'm going to select all these three divisions and give it some width and height, and also I'm going to position it. Okay, let us start giving some width and height to all three containers. For the hover hand, I'm going to use 150 pixels. because it is smaller compared to minute hand and seconds hand, 150 pixels. So the next one is minute. For that, I'm going to use a width of 200 pixels and 200 pixel side, because it is little bigger compared to her hand. So for the second hand, I'm going to use a width of 250 pixels and height of 250 pixels, because it is biggest compared to her and minute hand. So after that, I want to position it. So for that, I'm going to give a border so that I can trace the position. First, let us give some border to it. So border, same thing, 1 pixel and solid black color border. So to trace the position where the division is positioned. So now we can see all three divisions has been positioned in this manner. So I will use a property called display flex so that it'll come inside the clock division. So if I use display flex in the clock, the elements which are inside this element are becomes childs of that. So now it has been added. Now I want to have a position absolute so that all things will come in the center. So after that, I'm going to add hover hand, minute hand, and the center position. For that, I'm going to use a pseudo element called before. I'm adding a small box inside the clock container, inside the clock division, so width of 10 pixels, height of 10 pixels, and a background color of a black. Let us see where it is located. Yes, it is exactly located in the position. So I'm going to make it round using border radius 50%. Then I'm going to have a border of white color so that it looks cleaner and solid and white color border. And I'm going to use a Z index of 100 just to make it is above all other things. So now I'm going to add an hour and using the same pseudo element called before. So for this, I'm going to copy the same code and paste it here. But here the width is 8 pixels and the height of 75 pixels. So let us see where it is located. Yes, it is located in the top corner. So Z index will be 10. So now I'm going to copy the code and repeat it twice, one for minute and one for hour. One for second. For the minute, I'm going to have a width of 4 pixels and a height of 100 pixels. A Z index will be 11. Yes, the minute has been added. Now I want to copy the code and paste it for second hand. So second, here also same thing. The only thing is width and height. Here I'm going to use a 2 pixel of width and 150 pixels of height. So Z index will be 12. So let us see where it is located. Yes, all three has been located at the top corner. We have to bring it into center. So for that, what I'm doing is I'm going to use a flex property called display flex and justify content. Justify content, if I use a justify content, all three will be in the center. I think, yes, all three has been come to center. Now we don't need a border. I'll remove all the borders now. It looks, the only thing which is remaining is adding the JavaScript code so that our clock starts running. So first I'm going to access all the HTML elements using get elements by ID. First, I'm going to have a variable name, not a constant, r is equal to document.get element by ID r. So the next one is minute. That's why I've given an ID name in the HTML document so that I can access the same thing in the JavaScript. Yes, minute hand is over. Now we'll access the seconds hand. So seconds, that I'm going to give a name as second. and here the ID name. So yes, it is done. Now we'll access the time using inbuilt JavaScript method called date. Let r is equal to date dot get hours. So it is going to, this particular variable is going to have the r. I'm going to multiply it by 30 because the transition will be for the hour and it will be 30 degrees. So for minute, date dot get minutes, and I'm going to multiply it by 6. It is a simple calculation. If you do it, you'll understand. It is just for the rotation and it is going to give the ratio so that a clock is running in the proper ratio. I'm going to multiply it by 6. Then I need to have a transform property so that the clock is rotating. So for that, I'm going to use a JavaScript property called style.transform. It is actually a CSS property, but we can access through JavaScript. So hour.style.transform is equal to rotate. Rotate Z means you are rotating the element about Z axis. So this is a simple calculation to calculate the ratio so that all the hands will be running in a corresponding ratio. So after that, I'm going to have the same property twice, one for minute hand and one for second hand. And the ratio will be different for minute hand and second hand. So here it will be just minute. And next will be second. So change the ratio. I think now we have added all the transform property. Oh, it is not going to be visible in the browser because we are not yet linked the JavaScript file to the HTML document. Let us link the JavaScript file to the HTML document. Okay, now all three hands are moved to some certain positions, but it is not at all running. We'll make it dynamic. So this hour hand is not looking good. For that, I'm going to add a property called border. So it'll look much better now. I'm going to use a border radius property for all three hands so that the design of the clock is very good and it looks much better now. Yes. And the only thing which is remaining is the clock motion. So for that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a JavaScript method called setInterval. In that setInterval, I'm going to move all this code inside the method. And this is going to give a certain motion after certain time interval. So yes, our clock is running now. The clock looks very great. This is because of the neuromorphism effect which we applied. In the next video, I am going to explain you the concept behind the neuromorphism effect and also modifying the simple code which we used in this project to obtain different neuromorphism designs. Thank you. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and share the video as much as possible. Thank you once again.